Hello and welcome to yet another video. Today we have a board that we had multiple times before. It's a B450 Aorus Elite from Gigabyte. I don't know why, but these just keep dying. Multiple of these pop up for me. And yeah, they just end up at my place so many times. So yeah, I'm not too sure why especially these B450 Gigabyte ones are dying so much or have so many problems. But I don't have any info on what is wrong with the board. I only had a no start from the previous owner. So I'm not even sure if a no start means that it reacts to the power button and doesn't start, or if just it doesn't do anything. So no reaction to the power button. But let's find that out together. So, we have a 2200G in here, we have one stick of RAM, and let's see for the passive power consumption. And it's about 200 milliamps. That is quite normal. So that isn't telling us anything. So let's get a power button and a speaker also onto here. So let's press the power button. And we do have reaction. We have CPU, we have DRAM. And let's see now. We're stuck on DRAM so far. Didn't hear any beep. We restart with DRAM and CPU. The amperage seems to be stuck. So we do have constant current currently with 2.4 amps. And we keep cycling with CPU and RAM. Let's see if it's actually RAM training or we might have an issue with RAM. So with one of the data lines, maybe. So we're still stuck on DRAM LED after quite some time. So let's try the first obvious thing, which would be to reseed memory and try a different channel. Let's use a different channel of memory and see if that can help. So let's see again, turning the board on, going from CPU to DRAM. Now let's see if we get further than DRAM. And we're still restarting with CPU and DRAM. And power consumption is still basically stuck. We only have a little bit of rising power consumption because the processor keeps getting hotter. And that makes the power consumption go up all the time, just a little bit by bit. But it seems like we do have a RAM issue. And because it happens on different channels, we might have a problem with its power delivery. It could also be a BIOS problem. I've seen BIOS problems causing DRAM LEDs like this. So let's turn it off, try different channels, and I'm also going to try some different memory. Well, we've tested both channels. Let's now just test different slots if they reacted differently. So I've now tested each and every single bank of RAM or the slot of the RAM, every single one, and all four same show the same behavior, going to RAM LED and then stuck power consumption and sometimes restarting going from CPU to DRAM again. So I don't think that it is RAM training because it took way too long and happens on every single bank. So right now my train of thought would be that one of our power supplies for the RAM is missing because it happens on every single channel, and we will have a look at that. But before doing that, I would like to get my RAM tester in here and see for the data lines if we have any broken connection. So it's way too bright in my room because it's the middle of the day and the sun is shining through my big windows. And the LEDs are very faint on here. But in the first channel, all of the LEDs light up that need to be lit. So that doesn't seem to be the problem in the first slot. I will do the other slots. And because you can't see anything anyways, I'm gonna just tell you if I find anything. So I wasn't able to find any problems regarding the data lines. So let's go under the microscope and have a closer look at all of the voltages that are responsible for memory. So let's start up right at the bottom of the RAM slots. And very often VPP is located here or close to here, but I don't think it is this time. So nothing here looks obvious. Let's move further along here. Got the buck converter, linear regulator. That is for fan, pretty sure. And here we probably have the VDDQ, so the 1.2 volts. Everything looks fine here. And that's mostly it. So nothing obvious for now. It could also be a BIOS issue, like I've said before, for the RAM. Let's look around the CPU socket. If we have any damaged components, maybe. But I wouldn't expect that. I would expect that if there's like a CPU LED, but with stuck memory, I don't expect this behavior. And the slots look mostly fine as well. Let's look at the back side. But there's basically nothing to see here. It all looks very clean. So all of the traces look clean going to the CPU, all of the data lines. So let's get to measuring the actual voltages for the RAM. So let's go first go into resistance mode. And let's see for some of the inductors that are close here. Down here, 670 ohms. Okay, don't know what that coil is. Let's look at this coil right here, 5.3 kilo-ohms, so that should be fine. And let's look, is this the output? No, this is probably the other side of the high side. 250 ohms on memory. Okay, so nothing of that is very decisive for me or like really is telling for anything. Let's see if we have voltages. So let's now connect up the power supply again. So we turned on and let's press the power button. And let's see if we have voltages. So it's starting up now. Let's see, do we have voltage here? 1.8 volts. Do we have voltage here? We have 2.5, so VVP is also present. Let's see, do we have voltage here? And we have 1.2 volts also. Very interesting. We seem to have all of the voltages that are necessary. Let's try that again while we have memory actually installed and see if maybe we have a voltage drop on any of the voltages. So let's try that again. 1.8 volts still present. 2.5 volts present. And 1.2 volts present. There's one more, which should be, I think, 3.3 volts. There's a voltage sometimes that is called SPD that might be necessary. But what I expect is that this is actually a BIOS issue because we have the connection for the data lines. And we do also have all of the connection for the voltages, so VPP and VDDQ. I might have a look at SPD if that is missing or not. One more thing is that there might be a knocked off resistor that is maybe sending the power good signal to the SIO. That could be one more thing why we don't have RAM. But that might be actually before the reset state is getting taken off. So I would point towards the BIOS right now that might have a problem. But before I go to flashing the BIOS, I will have a look around the SIOs and the sub SIOs if there's anything broken there. So I couldn't find any damage around the SIO and the sub SIOs. So what I will be doing is I will be desoldering this chip and I will be looking at its firmware and will be flashing a new firmware on there. And then we will see if that will have a difference for our board here. There's no header on this board where I could connect. So I will be desoldering it. Okay, one more thing that came to mind was I didn't try to reset the BIOS on this. So this is one of the most obvious things that I should have done from the beginning on, because if we have a BIOS issue before just flashing the BIOS, ju let's just remove the BIOS battery, find the clear CMOS header, and try that. So I've reset the BIOS. Let's now see if that already has a difference on it. I should plug some memory in there before I do that. Let's see. So let's see, same behavior so far. CPU, VRAM. Yeah, DRAM. VRAM, yeah, sure. Power consumption looks very similar to before. And we still get resetting CPU and DRAM. So yeah, so that didn't help. But that gives me peace of mind that it wasn't just an easy case like that. Okay, so let's go over to desoldering the BIOS chip and flashing it. The BIOS now has been flashed. Let's see if we have any change now. Let's see, CPU, DRAM, and VGA. Yes. Also, the lights came on very interestingly. This is an APU. If I'm fast enough, we might actually get a blue boot screen out of this. Let's see. VGA is connected. Let's see, there's a BIOS beep and there's our boot screen. Very, very nice to see. Yep, and there's our boot screen. That is very nice to see. Let's connect the keyboard up here and we are in BIOS. Very nice. I will be building this board up with a normal CPU that I can run some stress tests and with a CPU cooler. Populate all of the RAM memory and put an M.2 into here and then we will see each other again. So, and now. LINPACK has passed, so the stress test was successful. We have a GPU connected to here, and we also do have RAM on here. All four DIMMs are populated. And yeah, what can I say? To take away from this video is what you need to check in order when you have a stuck DRAM LED. So what you can check is data lines connection. So the connection between the RAM and the CPU. You might even need to put in a different CPU because sometimes the controller for the memory, as far as I know, is on the CPU. And sometimes that can also cause problems. Third thing is the voltages of the memory. So SPD, VDDQ, and VPP, the 2.5 volts. And you also could check VTT, but VTT is more like necessary mostly for the CPU to turn on. But that is another voltage. And thirdly is definitely the BIOS. The BIOS can cause issues like that. Even though it initializes after the CPU startup, it still can be a BIOS issue. Another thing could be knocked off components, and especially if you have sub-IOs like on this board, that could also be a problem. So hopefully you learned something if you ever encounter a DRAM problem that you know what to look for and can fix the issue. So thank you very much for watching. This was Mainboard Medic. All of my tools are linked in the description. Hope to that you subscribe and that I can see you in the next video. Bye.